1954 Motorola TS-602. This is a massive black and white, maybe one of the biggest black and white tubes made. I know there was a Dumont. I don't know if it uses the same tube, but a little initial analysis and consultation suggests that this is a very rare set. And I am going to measure this tube. And the way we measure these is we measure them diagonally. And don't ask me why, probably a way of scamming the system. But yeah, it appears to be about 24 inches. Okay, see, you measure these diagonally, right? It's the easiest way to inflate the number. So the cabinet is in maybe a 6 out of 10, 5 out of 10. It would clean up. I think a little Restora finish would, it's pretty beat up down there. A little Restora finish might buff this out, but let's have a look at the guts because, and I thought I had the back to this monster, but I do not have the back. I haven't done anything to it. I did kind of peek at it, but it's as it came from a house I picked up a bunch of sets at, an estate. So let's see. It's a pretty impressive vertical output transformer. It looks like it is a power transformer set or a partial power transformer set. Still got a lot of Motorola branded tubes in it. There's a Sylvania Motorola. There's a tongue sole back there. But the high voltage cage has been removed, which is never a good thing. Black Beauty for the win. This kind of looks like it was, it almost looks like it was viciously crumpled up. What's this? The schematic. Jeez, that's bad. A collection of dead spiders here. K1 freaking silver fish. CP4A. Maybe the Dumont was a 30-inch. So, yes, it is a partial, looking at this power supply, my brain is stuttering. What are they doing here? So, it looks like they're getting 6.3 volts off the transformer, so it's a filament transformer, but then they've also got an auto former tap here that works as part of this doubler circuit. What kind of... You got two rectifiers in parallel, two rectifiers in parallel. Then they've got the two capacitors that are part of the doubler circuit. And then where is this going? Man, leave it to Motorola to come up with some kluky doobler. Oh, focus. Okay, so the focus coil on the neck of the CRT is in parallel, essentially, with this capacitor. It has a variable resistor there. Yeah, what an interesting power supply. It's kind of like a hybrid between line operated and hot chassis. I mean, it's definitely hot. I would consider this hot chassis. I mean, line through transformer through 200 microfarad capacitor to ground is definitely a sizzle pony crackle point. Okay, continuing our analysis. So the yoke is disintegrating. The plastic of the yoke is disintegrating. And ooh, do we have asbestos, or what is this? What is this? Some kind of tacky-ass gimmicky antenna setup? They don't show that on here, but why would they? It's embarrassing. Oh, well, channel 3 comes in best on 20, and channel 7 comes in best on 17, and channel 5 comes in best on 14. So it must be like polarized of some type of polarized, and when you rotated it, changes the polarization. That's an award winner right there. I deserve a Nobel Peace Prize for that analysis. Okay. Where's the asbestos? So let's have a look at this flyback. And the flyback is caked with dead spiders. Now, I've never seen a fly... Boy, this is really caked with dead spiders. I've never seen a flyback in one of these black and whites go bad. That looks like that was a fire there. Let me stand by. I got dead spiders blowing in my face. So our high voltage potential on this is 16 kilovolts. I wouldn't consider that high by color standards, but it's probably pretty high by black and white standards of the day. Anyway, back to this. It's kind of hard to tell because it's been sitting for 50 years, but it looks like there was a bit of a violent carbon tracking and burning here. That definitely looks like carbon tracking to me. Crunchy, crunchy. Yeah, Zenith Color Sets did a lot of this, and the solution was simply to take a Dremel and just cut all the carbon tracking out and fill it with silicone where if there was anything that needed support. But we don't know if it burnt through any of the leads from the dead spider coil. Got a doorknob capacitor down there. That's like an additional, that little thing at the bottom of the socket's like an additional little filter capacitor. So anyway, the first thing to do is to test the CRT. If the CRT is no good, and then this might make a nice fish tank. Looking at the color of the rear cup in here, it is definitely, to me, it seems a bit brownish blue. See, look past the filament wires there, see the bluing of the metal, and see how the metal's a yellowish brown. That would suggest that, to me, that this is a very high hour CRT, but maybe that's why it was retired, not this. You know, we would hope that that's why it was retired, not a bad CRT, but we need to start by testing it. Okay, 24CP4A, 6.3B1. Of course, we want to go to black and white. We'll turn that all the way up. 6.3, right there. See if it's glowing. And it is glowing. That's a good idea, or a good sign, or something good. Shorts. Gut cutoff or gun balance, and emissions. Any movement at all? Anybody home? Check 1, 2, 3. I mean, this thing is dead. There's not even a hint of life there. Let's go up. 6.3. It's about 7. It's about 8. Yes, I don't know. Hell, we'll go up even higher. 8 volts. Let's take it up here to... 2 high. That's getting pretty high. That's about 8 volts. And yeah, it's screaming in there, isn't it? Okay, shorts, gun balance, and emissions. Hello, anybody home? I mean, it is dead. It's like open cathode dead. Well, I've let it cook for about 10 minutes and nothing, so I'm gonna... I hit it any harder, I'm gonna break it. Let me grab the Beltron and we'll get a second opinion. just in case the test equipment's taking a dump. Getting a second opinion from the Beltron. Doctor number two says the Libertarian suicided himself. You know what I might do? I might reflow these. Although they look really good. I'm looking at them under a magnifying glass. But I've seen where, and I've heard of, and I've seen where solder will build up an oxide layer between, it'll break away and build up an oxide layer between a wire and a connector like this. That's why you never solder crimp connectors. Soldering crimp connectors is a no-no. Not only will it not be approved on the legal tip, it will fail because the solder can build up an oxide layer, an insulative oxide layer, and stop conducting. So I'm going to grab the iron and reflow these just to torco crinkulate my own Xyla crinkler. I hope it doesn't feel like it's broken, but I don't know. I could just take it off too. I'm gonna just pull it off. At this point, I got nothing to lose, really. A torch will do this also, but you can see they're already melting. See them melting? It looks like they're all good and like the solder was flowed on each one of them. What I'm going to do is I'm going to slide this forward. This is the ion trap. And I'm going to get some Windex and clean this off and see if I can see inside of it with a paper towel, maybe where it's broken. Not that I could actually see it, but I'm looking at the cathode wire. And okay, see the filament? Okay, see the tube, the little tube in the middle? And there's those two tabs right in the center of the camera that are the two leads that are right in the middle of the camera. They're bent over and they're going to those two what look like white wires that go to that coil. That's the heater. Okay. Then below that, you see that other wire right there? That is the cathode. So that little wire that's on the pin, the two pins below, you have the two pins for the heater, then the one below it is the cathode. See, it kind of loops back right there and then goes forward and connects to what looks like the bottom of the tube. That is the cathode connection, and sometimes that will break. That little wire will break free from the outside of that metal tube. Now, I can't see it here. All I can say is that thing looks baked. I mean, that cathode tube is dark blue. And I can't really get an angle on it here to where... Come on, focus. So there's the little wire. There's the filament leads and then the cathode connection below it. And yeah, you just can't quite get the right angle to see if it's actually still connected. It doesn't look like it's broken. You know, maybe I'll try resoldering this thing. I was very careful not to touch these wires so I could hopefully get it back in. I'll tin these and I'll solder it back on, but yeah, my hopes are not too high. Hopes are not too high. Looking at this, if any of these weren't making contact, it was the top one right there. The one all the way to the right. See how crusty and burnt it looks? The rest of them are kind of silver, and that one's kind of dark. I need to clean that out before I solder it. Wow, I think I actually lined it up and got it back on there. Holy crap, I should go buy a freaking lottery ticket right now. That's incredible. Okay, I cleaned all those leads off. I tried to clean all the tubes out. Let's flow it and see if there's any difference. Okay, unfortunately, I think I've given this one my best shot. I hit it. I'm gonna go up kind of high on the filament voltage here. I hate to pop this thing, but I mean, it is just so dead. You can't rejuvenate something that there's nothing to rejuvenate. I mean, if you're not, don't have anything to bite onto, you can't bite, you know? You gotta have something to bite onto there. And I mean, that is screaming hot right now. It's practically white and just nothing. Did it come up a little? I'm gonna try unplugging it. I mean, just nothing. Like zero. Yeah, I don't know what to say here. You know, I would... Well, look at how the DAG is coming off. I would really like to see this thing work. I mean, this is really high on my list. We even have the schematic right here, and it looks like the way this is designed, it's designed for serviceability. In this one, you don't have to pull the CRT out. The CRT is on its own support. This will just come out independent of the CRT, and this is going to be filled with wax paper capacitors that would have to be changed, but we could still resurrect it and get it to work with a minimum. I would really like to see this work, this massive black and white. Wow, what a display piece this would be. I'm pulling the chassis out just so we can have a look at the bottom, and I gotta say, as far as ease of serviceability, this thing is beautiful. Everything plugs into the chassis, including the twin lead for the antenna wire. Motorola really made nice stuff. So I got the chassis out. Oh, I got the wire going to the speaker right here. It literally takes like 5 minutes to get the chassis out. So is this copper plated? Is that what these are? I know this is the same as a little 7-inch set. I think a lot of Motorola's had this copper colored chassis. Very beautifully built. Well, I mean, it's sloppy chaos, but for the time, this was kind of the standard. Seleniums. I guess these are our doublers. Maybe that's why they were paralleling these. on the schematic, there's probably two paralleled in each stack. And lots of black beauties. Or bumblebees, or whatever you want to call them here in the high voltage department. Wonder how this looks in the sun. Wax, wax, wax. All these red ones are paper. I see there are two top hat diodes in here, one right here and one here that's just got the connections floating in air. So those were obviously probably to substitute these. And maybe that's what happened to the flyback when they replaced these with the silicon top hats. The high voltage went up so high that it drove the high voltage up and caused the thing to carbon track. Yeah, lots of black beauties. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and they suck. They gotta go. They're always short and leaky, and a lot of times they crack open. Nothing beats the quality of this stuff built in the 50s. As far as like the chassis and the controls, just such good quality. All this stuff sucks. The capacitors are junk, the resistors drift, but the basic building blocks, I guess, are okay. So look at the top. Where'd that tube shield go? I'm pretty sure that was on there. That burnt pretty good. That probably filled the house with some good smelling smoke. Made Daddy want to light up his pipe. Burn some ground resistors.